are you anyway? You look familiar.
I noticed you're looking a little bit depressed. What's the matter?
It's this football team I've inherited. Here, take a look at this.
No, I have one.
Got an offensive line that averages 171 pounds. Got a quarterback who's a junior only through three passes. Look at the times on these defensive backs. We're slower than molasses in February. How are we going to be successful with a team like this?
Don't worry. You're going to have them dancing in the aisles. And everybody's going to love you.
Play with class and character. That's the most important thing, you know.
Of course.
Hey, what was that? Let's go left.
And what about our goals? And are we going to beat Valley Christian? Are we going to win the league championship? Will we make it to the playoffs?
Don't worry about it.
How do you know all this? Who are you anyway?
I'm the ghost of football's future. Just put your hand on my shoulder and follow me.
Could have had the greatest show on earth, but the Knights decided their show played better in the skies. So, led by a Mouse Davis-designed offense and a defense that played over its head, Menlo regained sole possession of the Bay 6 League title for the first time in 4 years and maintained its reputation as a team worth getting excited about.
Look at them yo-yos, that's the way you do it.
My name is Paul Francis Sullivan. I'm a junior. I'm a Democrat. I'm a Catholic. I'm a playwright. I'm an actor. I'm a singer. I'm an Ashley McFall impersonator. I wear these, and I play a little defensive line on the side.
Jim McKinley, senior, quarterback. Need I say more?
Mark McAllister, Harlan McGee. Oh, junior running back, defensive end.
Chris Palm, number 23, defensive back.
That's all.
I'm Tom Ward, number 20. I'm a senior. Have a poem that explains it all. The roses are red, violets are blue. I beat Vard out at defensive back and score more chicks than him too.
Yeah! Kermit Klum. I'm a junior at the offensive line and defensive line.
Holger Besch, senior, number 74, offensive line. Injured reserve, Brandon Stevens, number 2, sophomore, utility receiver.
Bo Hoban, junior quarterback.
I'm Dave Osborne, and I play defensive end, and I'm a senior, and I'm also known as Soup, Oz, the Wizard. That's about it.
This is Bakir Begovic, junior, number 70. I've got a lot to say.
Victor Vasquez, number 59, junior. Offensive guard, defensive end, also known as Squez.
Floriani, junior, unskilled position.
Greg Barker.
Greg Barton, junior, number 65, lineman, brain surgeon.
My name's Brad Mays, I'm a junior, a perfect example of the versatile athlete of the 80s. I was a junior, I'm a senior now. I played quarterback, running back, defensive back, guard, and of course, linebacker.
Tim Allen, junior, middle linebacker.
Jem Arthur, number 85, linebacker, and after game festive All-American.
Hi, I'm Justin Fahey. I play lineman and linebacker occasionally.
I'm back. Yeah, my name is Anthony Kienert. I'm number 66. I'm a senior this year. And this, among others, are the creation of Tom Hudson.
I'm Kevin Miller. I'm a senior. I play center and nose guard.
I'm Bart Curtis, senior, halfback, and defensive back. And a message to Tom Ward, I go for quality, not quantity.
Tim Kienert, senior, defensive end, number 35.
Shane Stent, call sign Maverick. I'm number 38, 83. I play receiver, halfback, tight end, punt returner, quarterback, and I'm the best.
Name's Kevin Pooler, sophomore, and I play defensive tackle.
Mike Long, 44, senior linebacker.
32, Mike.
And 32.
Aaron Lebarski, you can call me Lubo. If you're Johnny Crockett, you can call me Lebo. I'm number 43, I'm tight end. I'm a senior.
Justin Hike, number 72, guard and linebacker, sophomore.
Ralph Irvin, number 56, senior linebacker and strong guard, and the originator of the Menlo style and dues.
Sean Filer, I'm a sophomore, and I'm a backup tight end and free safety.
My name is John Farquhar. I'm a junior, number 89. I play wide receiver, defensive tackle.
I'm Ian Henderson. I'm a senior wide receiver, and this is Vard Curtis's elusive self-juke move.
Dan Mosier, sophomore, center, linebacker, also known to have severe facial distortions.
Jeff Weinstock, senior defensive back.
Matt Sheen, number 36, sophomore and backup defensive end.
Although Ian Henderson and the rest of the 1988 Menlo Knights could cover a lot of ground on the run, the Knights' offensive highlights in this record-setting season consisted almost entirely of the airborne variety. The forward pass was not a new phenomenon at Menlo School, of course, but the run-and-shoot offense installed by coaches Ashley McFall and Gary Rikus gave a totally new meaning to Menlo's reputation as a passing powerhouse. Virtually every play, All-State quarterback Jim McKinley had a field full of capable receivers to throw to, and he used them effectively, passing for over 3,200 yards and a state record 44 touchdowns. And as John Farquhar shows here, All-State receiver Henderson was by no means McKinley's only target. Six different Knights had 21 or more receptions during the 11-game season. All told, the Knights amassed almost 3,500 passing yards as they went on to set 18 school offensive records. Most impressively, the Knights scored more than 30 points in 8 different games as they set a school record for most points in a single season. It's a nice day to start again. With a front line averaging only 171 pounds, Coach McFall knew his offense could only move the ball consistently by being what he likes to call assignment perfect. And although the Knights played well in early season games like this one against Fort Bragg, it wasn't until the end of the season that the line and the rest of the Knights appeared to have achieved McFall's goal. In a tough 3-game stretch against Valley Christian, Terra Nova, and Calistoga, the run and shoot ran up 150 points and showed that Mouse Davis's revolutionary offense may yet bounce back and become the wave of the future.
Pick it up. Take me back home, man. There's nothing fair in this world. In this world, and there's nothing sure in this world, and there's nothing pure in this world, and if there's something left in this world, start again.
you want with the night day for white wedding.
For last in 1988. During a three-game sequence concluding the regular season and beginning the playoffs, Menlo appeared invincible against, well, anybody. After the blowout of Valley Christian ended the league schedule, Menlo took on the big boys. Terranova High would eventually win the Central Coast Section's Division II North title for schools much larger than Menlo. But in the regular season finale, Menlo made the Tigers look like toddlers. We'll be right back. two consecutive brilliant performances, the Knights' finest show was yet to come. In the North Coast Section Class A playoff opener against Calistoga, Menlo was virtually unstoppable and immovable. And the record-setting offense shone. 8 touchdown passes by quarterback Jim McKinley tied a California state record and helped McKinley break the record for touchdown passes in a season. And with over 400 yards passing, the Knights seemed ready to soar to still greater heights. And 7-game winning streak finally came to an end on an otherwise sunny day in November as the Clear Lake Cardinals solved enough of Menlo's mysteries to edge the Knights 21-14. But many plays that day still reflected the brilliance of Menlo's 8-3 season, a championship season that will be long remembered. Run and shoot wasn't the only new system at Menlo in 1988. On defense, the Knights employed a new 5-3 alignment designed to stop the run. The result, ironically, Menlo had its best season ever defending against the pass. In the 5-3, 8 Menlo defenders were responsible for stopping the run. So the Knights forced most of their opponents to go to the air more often than they would have liked, with predictably fortuitous results for the Knights, who recorded a school record 28 interceptions. Although Menlo had some trouble against the run early in the season, the 5-3 came through and clamped down on rushers during the remainder of the schedule. It was Menlo's offense, of course, that recorded most of the big plays, but the defense allowed opponents very few, giving up only 4 touchdown plays of more than 20 yards all season. And while limiting opponents' big plays, the defense came up with a few of its own.
Don't stop, come on. today?
Valley!
Who do we play today?
Valley!
You want them?
Yes!
You want them?
Yes!
Go get them!
Yes!
Yeah!
Like every team, Menlo has its big game, and each year that game comes against Valley Christian. But in 1988, Menlo's big game became more than that. It was the perfect game. In the midst of a great season, it was Menlo's perfect moment.
Call it.
Tails.
You want a tail? It is a tail. You have your choice of deferring to the second half, receiving, kicking, or defending a goal. You defer to the second half. That means you get your choice whether you want to receive, kick, or defend the goal.
We like the ball.
You want the ball. You want to receive. That gives you another choice. Which way do you want to kick? They're going to receive. Now you got to kick. Which way are you going to kick?
I'm going to kick.
All right, put your backs towards the goal you're going to defend. All right, the blue team, Menlo, is going to receive. Gentlemen, shake hands. Let's get ready to play football, huh?
Yeah. Hey.
Okay, this is the middle of the field, right here.
And what has come to be the annual Bay Six League Championship game is underway. Monero lines it off the front line of Menlo, and a good opportunity for Valley Christian, but it looks like Menlo did cover the ball. Falling on the ball for Menlo was Kevin Miller, and as a result, Menlo ends up with good field position at their own 45-yard line.
Of me. I'm only one, but not alone. My finest day is yet unknown.
Nobody expected this out of you guys, and you guys have given more than anybody could ask of you. It's just a great win here today. I've never seen more heart and more desire, more willingness to do what it takes to be great than you guys have done. I'll never forget you guys.
Yeah! Oh, yeah!